Well, I was driving into work, and Subaru clearly had a bad alternator, and I just hadn't had a chance to fix it. I thought maybe it was going to make it. It didn't make it, so I'm on the side of the highway, pulled off onto an on-ramp, and I just got to wait for a tow truck. It sucks. Should have just fixed it yesterday, but I didn't have time. I had a business dinner, so I didn't get home until like 8:30, 9 o'clock at night. Ah, fucking Subaru. At least I was able to get off the road, so I'm just sitting here on the side of the road waiting for a tow truck. Fucking A. Here's what happens when you try and start it. Yeah, that's good. So the battery's dead and the alternator's dead. So just to make sure that it's exceptionally torturing, my stupid dash cam is stuck in an infinite loop of rebooting itself. And I tried unplugging it and stuff like that, and that doesn't seem to work, so I may have to kill myself or throw that thing out the window. Oh, thank God I got to stop doing that stupid reboot cycle. That was gonna drive me nuts. Oh man, so that white car rear-ended this gray car that just left. They stopped and exchanged numbers, but it didn't look very bad. I was like not paying attention. I thought I heard something, but then I saw them stop. They just checked the cars and it was no big deal. Morning drama. Nice. Someone's cruising into work in a little Shelby Cobra. That's a good way to drive to work. Well, just got a text from the tow truck company. Said it's gonna be over an hour. It's tempting to walk home. I'm literally like 1.5 miles from home, so. Oh. Where did it come from? There it is. Shit. Tow truck just drove by. Hopefully it wasn't mine. Because they're supposed to be here in the next 5 to 10 minutes, so... Although it was not a flatbed, and he wouldn't have been able to tow this thing anyway, since it's all-wheel drive, so... It's probably best it wasn't mine, or... If it was, they screwed up, but... Anyway, every time a diesel truck drives by, I'm like, ooh, get my hopes up, and then... Nope. So, been here about... getting close to 2 hours now. Hour and 40 minutes. So. Oh, diesel? Nope, just a big fucking truck. Damn it! Alright, so the situation just pissed me off tremendously. So, so I called, you know, I had USA dispatch a tow truck, and they said its ETA was 11:04. It is now 11:48. So USA contacted me and said, did the tow truck get there? And I said, no. And then they said, okay, you know, call this number. So I call it. They transfer me to the tow truck company, and the tow truck company claims that they never got dispatched to me. So I've been sitting here for 2.5 hours for no fucking reason, doing nothing, with no tow truck heading my way. Pretty awesome. So I call back USA and I'm like, hey, I need a tow truck still, and they're like, yeah, we just talked to the tow truck company, and they said they didn't get any dispatch from us. I said, great, get a different fucking tow truck company out here, and by the way, I'm going to abandon my vehicle now, so I have someone from work coming to pick me up, and I'm just going to leave the fucking Subaru here, because screw it. I mean, what's someone going to do, steal it? Firebomb it? I don't fucking care. It's USA's problem. It'll be an insurance claim, and whatever. So now I just gotta wait for a coworker, which should be a lot faster. I probably should have just walked home because it's only a mile and a half from home. But what a fucking annoying day this has turned out to be. So, all right, let's just wait for my coworker. Well, as you saw, I kind of had a crappy morning. So eventually, they actually came and got the Subaru and they dropped it off. And so now I need to replace the alternator. I was hoping to wait until the weekend to do it because I knew it was dying and I knew it was gonna die very soon, but it didn't quite. Today was the last day I was hoping to squeeze out of it before I needed to replace it, and it just didn't make it. So pressed my luck and, you know, luck ran out. So we'll do that. So we'll disconnect the battery, then we remove this little belt shield, and actually the bolt there, got the power cord here, we gotta undo that connector right there. It's kind of cool, the tensioner is this bolt right here, so actually we won't have to do any of the crazy tensioner stuff, we'll just pull that and it should drop the belt right off, so it should be pretty easy. Okay, got the belt covers off. At least got all the bolts off. This one doesn't apparently come off there, but they're all 10 millimeter, super easy.
Go, Megan.
Meg quickly swung home, but she's gonna go visit her coworker who just had a baby. So congratulations to her coworker. All right, so I disconnected the power cable. It's just a stupid fly. Just a little bolt right there. This comes off if you push on this piece right here. It'll pop out pretty easy. There is one bolt right here that we have to undo. Then there's this bolt, which is the tightening. It's like the jack bolt, and then there's a bolt right there. So we'll loosen up this bolt. We'll unscrew this bolt. That should cause the alternator to drop down. It'll loosen up the belt, and then we should be all set, and it should come right out. So as soon as I undid this bolt, the alternator flopped loose, so now I can get the belt out. There we go. And we'll inspect the belt, make sure there's no cracks. If there are any cracks, we'll replace it. I mean, it's probably only a few bucks, so we'll have to take a look at that. But now I just need to get this bolt off. And then we'll be all good. And just like that, we have an alternator! Woohoo! Yay, crappy alternator, it's broken. Alright, well, alternator is out. Now I just gotta wait for Meg to get home so I can take her car, because unfortunately the Ferrari's kind of blocked in. We'll go get the new alternator and take care of all that crap. Alright, decided to get a new belt, so got my new belt. Got the alternator, and it's dark out, so I got the lights set up over the car, so let's go install the new alternator. All right, attached the power cable and the little connector. Got this bolt through, so I need to tighten that bolt down, and then I'm gonna have to connect this bolt and align it with this guy, but first we'll have to put on the belt. All right, belt is on. Now we're gonna tighten up this bolt right here, which will pull the alternator up and tighten the belt, see? Like that. Okay, got this bolt sort of tight, but it's a little bit loose, so can I still crank on this? So you can see, if I crank this, it's gonna raise the alternator up and tighten up the belt. Ooh, there we go. That's probably pretty tight. All right. Oops, totally forgot this shield has to go behind that bolt. So I had to loosen it up and now I gotta put it back in there and I'll tighten that down. Alrighty, all back in place. Gotta put back on the battery cables and then we're ready to start it up. All right, battery's in. Moment of truth, let's try and start it. All right, let's see if it starts. Come on, well, I should let it sit for a second because, come on, there. Let's sit for a second because disconnecting the battery should let the ECU sit for a moment. That's probably good. Oh shit! Yes! Oh, yeah, bitches! She's alive! She's alive!
Oh, yeah, she's purring like a kitten. Look at that. Heck yeah. Well, that was just about as easy as it gets to do an alternator.